Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about Oracle Database Architecture. So first, Oracle Database software is designed to support architecture of instance and the database. So this is your instance, this is your database. So this is your database files like data files, control files, online redo log files, archive log files, flashback logs, redo log files. So this is your database physical files. So when you are talking about the instance, so instance consists of two things. One is a system global area, that is called as SGA, and another one is your background processes. So here these are the components of your system global area, that is a shared pool area, file, your database buffer cache, redo log buffer, large pool, Java pool, stream pool, and these are your background processes, PMON, SMON, RICO, MMON, MMNL and the other background processes. Fine, and this is your PGA area, fine, which contains the SQL work area, session memory, private SQL area, which is consist of one server process, and this is your client process, means whenever the client sends the request, it goes to your server process. Server process perform the whatever the activity you requested, like you are requested for the select statement, then it will select the data, fine, and it will give it back to your client process. So let's discuss the first thing that is very important, like if you selecting the data from the database, so what actually happen in the background, fine. So here this is your application server. So from the application server, one is your user process, that is your client process, fine, sending a request to your database server, fine. This is your application server, the database server. So second step, there is a server process is there, fine, server process is there. What it will do, fine, it will whatever the select statement you have given, that is goes under the as a third step to your SGA, fine. And here also the fourth step, that is the PGA is there, that is the syntax check is also done if it is the same statement is executed, okay. From the SGA, one component is there, that is the library cache. In the shared pool, we have one component that is called library cache. So here it will check the execution plan, fine, the execution plan of your SQL statement. And if it is large, it will just take the data from the large pool, fine, and directly from the database file, it can take from the using the large IO, large pool, and also it can take it from the database buffer cache and give it to your server process. Server process give it to the user process, and here it is going to be display your data. So whenever you are doing the select, statement execution on the database server, these are the processes are going on. Fine, you are just executing the statement select star from employee, but actually in the background all these steps are occur. So let's see this thing in detail. So user issues a select statement which is carried over to the database only after the connection is applied by, established using the listener by the user process, fine. So what is actually happened? First of all, the connection is established. Once the connection is established, after that your select statement is going to be executed, carried to your database by the user process. First, connection should be required by the using listener on the database server, okay. Second, as there will be the server process created for this user in the dedicated server architecture, SQL is passed into this PGA, fine. This is the dedicated server architecture, and this statement is passed into the PGA and in turn creates the cursor in it, fine. It will first create the cursor in it, fine. So the every SQL statement will have a cursor in the memory until the query execution is completed. So whenever you are creating, selecting the data from your Oracle database, so it will just first pass to the PGA, it will just create a one cursor, means it will just open your one cursor, whether it is a PLSQL statement or the normal SQL statement, fine, and it will remains open till your execution is completed, okay. Next, what happened after the cursor is created? Syntax checks will be let the query to be moved into the SGA. Next step, syntax check, fine. Syntax means whatever the statement you have written, that is correct or not as per the SQL statement, Fine, like you are writing select star from employee. But in case if you have not mentioned star, select from employee, so it will give you the error. So that is the your syntax checking. Okay. Now what happened in the 4, 5, 6 and 7? Now system will verify the query is already catched. Means previously the same user or any other user executed the same SQL statement like select star from employee. If yes, pick up the execution plan. If no, parsing happen and the new execution plan is created by the optimizer. Fine. See, this is the execution plan is already exist. Fine, syntax check is already done and that information is already available in the library cache of the shared pool. Then your parsing is not done again. But in case if it is not done, fine, it is going to be done again. Fine, and store those information under the library cache. If it is already done, it will just collect that information directly from the library cache. Parsing is not going to be done. Okay, now the data is pulled into the buffer cache with the help of the large pool to perform IO operations smoothly. Fine. Next is a catching the data. Select star from employee. Syntax is right, correct. Next step, taking the data. Fine. So what it will do? Pull out into the buffer cache, means whatever the data, if the data is there in the buffer cache, it will take the data from the buffer cache and give it to the user. But in case the data is not available in the buffer cache first time you are executing, on that time the data is taking from the database files. Fine. In the case of order by clause, fine, like you are doing the select star from employee, order by employee number, so sorting take place in the server process, that is the PGA, and data sent back to the user process. Now that query executed successfully, cursor area is released on the database server. Fine. So here if you are issuing the order by clause, so on that time what happened, that ordering of the data is done under the PGA. Fine. Under the PGA, one area is called, that is the short area where the sorting is done. And once the sorting is done, it is going to display your data, and at the end what happened, whatever the cursor is opened, okay, created, that is going to be released. Fine. So everything is completed. So this is the process is happen whenever you are selecting the data from the database. Next, a process is a mechanism in the operating system that can run the series of steps. So first is a client process. Fine. This process are created and maintained to the run the software code of an application program or a Oracle tool. Fine. So this is the first process, means whenever the, if you are using any applications or if you are connecting with the SQL plus from the client machine, this is the first process that is going to be created, that is the client process. Okay. Most environment have a separate computers for the client processes. Fine. Next is a background processes. So see here, background processes asynchronously perform the IO and monitor the other Oracle database processes to provide the increased parallelism for the better performance and the reliability. So few of the background processes are there, that is basically works for the better performance, and it will also works for the retrieving the data from the your database. Next, server process. So this processes communicate with the client process and interact with Oracle database to fulfill the request. This is the main process. Without this, you can't retrieve the data. Means whenever the client sending the request to the your database, what happened? One server process is there on the Oracle database server. Fine. It will just accept the request for the client process, like client is asking for the select star from employee. So what happened? Server process accept this request and interact with the database to fulfill the request. Okay. The process that perform the activity on behalf of the client, that is the process that actually execute the user's SQL statement. Fine. And that is referred to as a server process. See, client is not executing the SQL statement on the database. Client sending the request, and that server process actually in the background executing that SQL statement and give it back to the client the data. When the client program wants to execute the SQL, it relies on the server process to execute the SQL and return the result. In the dedicated server environment, The dedicated server performs activities on behalf of only one client. This sort of server is started when the client connects, and it destroys when the client is disconnect. And dedicated servers are usually by default. So what is actually happen when the client connect to the database? One server process is established. When the task is done, client disconnected, server process is also going to be deactivated. Fine. And by default, in Oracle database environment, you have a dedicated server environment. Next is a shared server. So when the shared server performs the task on behalf of the multiple client, here one client, one server process. Here shared server performs the task on behalf of the multiple client. So here dispatchers are there. Fine. So if you have like millions of users on your Oracle database, so Oracle recommend using the shared server. But if you know like you have thousands of users, 5,000 users, 10,000 users, you know the number of users, fine, fixed number of users, on that time you can use the dedicated server environment. Next, parallel query servers. So Oracle can employ multiple parallel threads of processing to execute the single SQL statement, fine. So here at this moment what we are doing, only single query execution, but client to server environment. But here we have one option, that is a parallel query server. So parallelly you can execute the single SQL statement in the multiple ways, fine. So that is the your parallel query servers. Job and scheduler servers. So PLSQL program or the OS command in 11g can submit for the background and periodic processing. The job and scheduler server execute these commands in the background and schedule as per the requirements. Like any of the maintenance jobs are there, any of the reports are there, that you can just create the procedure, store procedure, or you can just schedule it. And whenever like in the 3 a.m. you are scheduling, so in the night every time it is going to be executed. So this is also one kind of processes. The processes or the thread in the Windows OS that perform the task on behalf of all the session or that platform Oracle internals activity are called the background processes. Right? So these are the all your called as a your Oracle background processes. Here are the some more significant Oracle background processes. So let's discuss about the Oracle database background processes. So here first is a listener. What the listener is doing? One or more listener process will be active on every host that contain the database server. Fine. The listener accept the request for the connection, and in the case of dedicated connection, create the server process and manage that connection. Fine. So what actually happened in the listener? In case if it is a dedicated environment, whenever the client send the request, one server process will be created. Okay. In case of the shared server connection, the listener passes the request to the dispatcher. Fine. What listener will do? It will send the request to the dispatchers. That means that mediates between the session and the shared server. So this is the medium. Dispatcher will do the other activity in the shared server architecture. So this is your listener. Next, database writer process. What it will do? Server process reads from the database files, but most of the time it's a database writer process that writes changes to this files. Means like you are inserting the data, you are updating the data, you are deleting the data. So whatever the changes are done on the database, that is done by the database writer process. This writer is a lazy writer, fine. Instead of writing the changes out immediately, it writes the changes at some convenient later time. So that's why it is called as a lazy writer. It is not immediately writing whatever the changes you are doing at same time, it is doing after the some time, like 5 second, 10 second, 15 second, whatever the depends upon the transactions. Okay. As a result, database sessions do not normally need to wait for the write to the disk. Fine. So what actually, once you write down the insert statement, after that you no need to wait for the sessions to be completed, transactions needs to be returned to the database files. Okay, you can just do the other activity. Okay. Although there are the direct IO modes in which sessions will write directly to the database files. So on that time, buffers will not come into the picture. Directly, whatever the transactions you are writing, that is directly returned to the your database IO. Next is your log writer buffer. So log writer writes the redo entries from redo-lock buffer in memory to the redo-locks. Means whatever the transactions are going on, create, alter, drop, truncate, that everything insert, update is recorded into the redo. Now the redo changes is available in the redo lock buffer, which is in the SGA component. That redo information should be returned to the your redo lock file. Fine. So that is written by the log writer background process. The log writer writes this entries periodically and always when the commit statement is issued. Means it is writing every 3 seconds, but in case if you are issuing a commit statement, immediately it will write down the data from the redo log buffer to the your redo log files. This is the your log writer process. Next, log archive process. So log archive copies the modifies redo logs to the archive logs that can recover the database if the disk failure occurs. So for that, what is required? You require to keep your database in the archive log mode. Fine. So whatever the redo log files copy is generated into the archive log, and in case of your failure of your database, on that time you can do the point in time recovery. And the next is the last one, recovery writer. So the recovery writer writes the undo information similar to the rollback segment information to the flashback log. Fine. So these are all your Oracle background processes. So in this session we have discussed about the Oracle database architecture in brief. Thank you.